Good luck! Bye! And I didn't need a crit to do it. Wow, incredible. Good afternoon, PokeSports. Welcome to the VGC Battle Sim Regulation G video, bringing you Pachirisu! I can smell Judy's tears from across the room. I'm just kidding. Anyway, Pachirisu's back on the channel. Of course, everyone's favorite little world champion is back here today, sitting next to his best friend, Maridon. Whew! I'm excited to try this out, because there's actually a lot of thought process on this team. I know it just looks like a Flutterfish team with a Pachirisu smacked on it, but it's not. Because Pachirisu is actually a very good partner for the Maridon. Maridon could sit there, set up its Electric Terrain, give itself the Electric Seed, free plus one in defense, and then you also have Calm Mind with Follow Me support from your Pachirisu, so you can be plus one in defense, plus one in special attack, and then plus one in special defense. Afterwards, you sit there, you either decide, do I want a Fairy Terror and blow things up with Dazzling Gleam, or do I want to click Electro Drift? Or, third option, do I want to click Parabolic Charge and heal all of the health that I've gotten damaged back at the very end? Not just that, the Maridon doesn't just heal itself. It heals the Pachirisu as well, because Pachirisu also has Volt Absorb and can support the Maridon by going for the Super Fang on very tanky targets, going for the Helping Hand to boost your anything even more. And of course, we all know Follow Me support as well. Also, once the Pachirisu inevitably goes down, you have Chiyu on the field to lower their special defense even further. This team is very special heavy. That's like the one of the few weaknesses this team does have. It's like every single Pokemon here is a special attacker except for a Grimmsnarl with Spirit Break, and that's pretty much it. But you know, you have a lot of ways to just take that further. You have the Chiyu to lower the special defense, you have the Pachirisu to help you with Helping Hand, and also help you with Super Fang just in case you're going against a very specially defensive target. Again, down to half HP is a lot easier to KO. Now, you could also Parabolic Charge next to your Blarsaluna. Blarsaluna's here with the Vacuum Wave, Blood Moon, Earth Power, and Hyper Voice. Kind of giving yourself a little bit of a Trick Room option there, and also just a good late game sweeper. Knocks things out at 1 HP with the Vacuum Wave. Just makes them sad. Fluttermane's here because Flutterfish combination. Also, Cover Cloak on Chiyu's kind of cool. You don't see that too often, but people do like to fake out Chiyu, so it's nice that it's there. And then last but not least, we have the Grimmsnarl with Fake Out Reflect, Light Screen, and Spirit Break, setting up the screens for our friends, making our Maridon a lot more tanky. And yeah, that's the team. That's the patchy team. Now, Shumate, thank you so much for going ahead and posting this team on the PokeSports Discord. If y'all want to go ahead and post this team on the Discord, you gotta join it. PokeSports.info has every link that you need. Buy yourself a hat, buy yourself a shirt, and that's the intro, folks. I hope I made that fast enough for people that say I take too long in these intros. Anyway, y'all excited to see the squirrel in action? Hit the like button down below, subscribe to PokeSports if you haven't done so already. With that said, let's get on to this video. Oliver with the Giratina Dozo. Blech. Disgusting to both of those things. Gosh, all right. Rillaboom in there in the middle, plus a Grimmie. I hate it here, but you know what? I don't see a great way of them stopping me from just like setting up some Calm Minds and clicking Parabolic Charge and never dying. So I'm gonna do that. Yep, that sounds like a plan. I'm gonna lead Maridon, I'm gonna lead Pachi, I'm gonna let them figure it out afterwards. I'll bring Chiyu in the back just because that'll help with the special defense on the opposing side of the field, because they do have a lot of special defense on that side. And then of course, you could never go wrong with the Fluttermane. I'm bringing everything with special attack. Newsflash, everything on my team is special attack, minus a Grimmsnarl. But you know what? Doesn't matter, we're gonna set up Calm Minds. Eventually, except for that Dozo. But eventually, we'll be able to just tear through their team. It's all good. Oliver, taking selfies with Pekarunt. I almost forgot that Pokemon's name just because it's never used. They're gonna lead Grimmsnarl and Giratina. Double GG lead. They're already saying GG before the battle starts. I have plans, actually. Believe it or not, I could just click Fairy Terror turn one. And I think I will. I think I'm gonna Calm Mind initially here. Okay, how about this? I Calm Mind first. And I Follow Me. For example. I use the Pachi for what Pachi typically is used for. That's okay. That's what the Calm Mind is for. I wonder what the Giratina is gonna do, because like, it's not Origin Form Giratina. So it's good. I mean, either Giratina can. Oh. So that's what the Giratina gonna do. Okay, I got another plan. New plan. Part two of my plan. Part two of my plan is going to be the Fairy Terra Calm Mind. Just in case they try to Draco Meteor me here. I'm throwing a Super Fang at this Giratina, predicting a Terastalization because they also don't want to take a Dragon move. It's a little risky of a play, but I'm going to do it. Come on, Giratina, you know you want a Terra. They're going to Heart Swap to Grimmie, fine. They just want to set up Light Screen and nothing else. They want to get rid of my terrain too, also fair enough. Could have actually clicked Terra this turn, but it's fine. I could have held Terra, I mean. We'll see what happens. My Terrastalization is going first. Come on, Giratina, I know you want a Terra too. You don't want to remain a Dragon type. Why would you want to do that? Yeah! Got him. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Now, please don't remain Ghost. Also perfect. We are both doing the same thing. Now I can actually use electric moves, though. I don't have to rely on anything else here. Calm Mind again! I'm doing it again! I mean business. My Pachirisu is going to do the majority of the damage here. Look at that damage. They Calm Mind again. This game is going to get spicy. We are going to get spicy this game. Yikes. All right, grassy terrain sucks a little bit. Lefty sucks a little bit. You know what? They're going to fake out this turn. I'm going to attempt the Parabolic Charge, but I know they're going to fake out this turn, so I'm still going to Super Fang this Giratina slot just to keep its health down as much as I can. I didn't expect this game to get this spicy this quickly. Oh, they don't fake out, so that's good news for me. That Parabolic Charge did not do damage. Okay, maybe I am going to have to rely on my Pachirisu for the damage. Yikes! Uh-oh, Patchy's taking a lot of health here. We got a Citrus Berry still intact. Are they gonna focus down my Pachirisu? Leave my poor thing alone, it's trying its best out here. Oh, he's Calm Minding again. Is that the brightest idea? I guess it's not a horrible idea for him either. Should I bother Parabolic Charging, or should I just switch on over to Dazzling Gleam, maybe. Maybe a Helping Hand and ID Gleam. I am at plus two, right? Because how bad is Parabolic Charge as a move? Oh, so that's why it did no damage. Okay, yeah, let's do Dazzling Gleam. Let's Helping Hand this Dazzling Gleam. Let's try to actually do some damage here. Let's try to do something meaningful, especially to the Rillaboom, even. Okay, perfect. I wanted to hit the Rillaboom this turn. I also don't have the Hadron Engine boost here either. It's a big reason why I'm not doing as much damage as I'm anticipating. Decent enough, I guess, but for plus two, that's kind of disappointing, I'm not gonna lie. I must be very defensive. What's my defense here? No. Timid, max speed, max special attack. Unless Hadron Engine literally just makes that much of a difference, guys. That's crazy. All right. At this point, I'm bringing out Chiyu. I'm bringing out the big guns. We're going to do some damage. Whether they like it or not, we're doing damage. Let's see if they can stop me. Bring out the big guns. We're lowering your defense now. Or special defense now. We're going to de-gleam again. I could snarl, but I'm going to go for the heat wave. Going to keep it nice and simple. A combination of these hits should hopefully do something here. Oh, they also have the light screen up. That's right. Gotta keep in mind the light screen is up here. Incin coming out. Welcome, Incin. I'm Cobra Cloak on Chiyu, so that they might not know that. That's a nice little best of one cheese that I have here on this team. 3D Gleam. Decent, I guess. Heat Wave does double connect. Okay, not as much as I'd want. They're gonna keep going. That's some greed if I've ever seen it. The fact that they're going to keep going. Now I'm worried. Paint me worried, because now I'm worried. What do you all think? Do you think they protect here? I could start snarling them if I am that worried. Oh, I think I keep gleaming though. I gleam and I heat wave again. I have to keep their health down. They haven't started attacking yet, and I'm terrified. Like, I am an all special team. So the Calm Mind is very annoying. Okay, they just protect. Whatever. So their instant's dropping here. Okay, or not, I guess. Protect, fake out. I never understood that play, but whatever. Just for some more lefties recovery, I guess. The second this light screen goes away, I get a severe advantage here, though. I pretty much just need this light screen to pop. This eternal light screen that hasn't gone away ever. Alright, grassy terrain is now gone. We've been in this battle for such a long time that terrain's had time to disappear. That is nuts. Without getting swapped out or changed. Keep in mind that even though Pachirisu is still in the grave right now, it's the only reason we have any damage on this Giratina to begin with. We degleam again. We keep this wet noodle fight going. Instant dropping to very low HP. We're not missing a single heat wave today. I would love a burn. I would need something to counteract that lefties as soon as possible. Bro, they are not messing around. They are continuing and continuing and continuing. They might even be Covert Cloak there. The fact that I haven't burned them yet is kind of crazy. Because now they're going to get the Rilla back on the field. Probably protect Fake Me Out again. I really think I just have to keep the pressure going. Like, I think I have no other choice but to keep the pressure going. Problem is, they're using pressure, and I'm losing Dazzling Gleams, and I'm losing Heat Waves. Thankfully, I have some PP ups here. Not on all my moves, but on most of them. So I'll take what I can get. Again, I think I just have to keep attacking here. There's no other play. Could I go for a Calm Mind to try to match his? Sure, I guess. But at the same time, can I? I don't know. I need this light screen gone, man. And I need a burn. I need a lot of things to happen and go my way. I need a crit! Let me break through what they got! Yep, they're protecting again. Just for some more HP. This is so annoying. They're gonna have to start attacking me soon too, though. Like, let's be honest, my guy. You haven't done damage to me yet. My heat wave is doing so little damage, I almost think that snarling is more optimal. It's a hard choice, though. It's a rough choice. What I could do is Calm Mind in between each of these protects. That might be a better play, I guess. To at least try to match his Calm Minds. But I think the only reason we still have some kind of a semblance of a chance in this game is because our pressure is not relenting. Alright, unfortunately, they still have the Grimmsnarl around to reset their screen for him. I'm gonna gleam again. I'm fishing for burn still. They're gonna reset the screen because they have to. It's the only reason they have a chance here. Is that screen is helping them out so much, and this Giratina is so stupidly tanky. All right, thankfully we straight one shot the Grim though. Bye. All right, they're down to the Giratina. I still have 3 full health mons on the field, and they're down to a singular Giratina. They finally decide to click Deep Pulse on my Chiyu and we live. Good. So they're going to protect. I'm going to Calm Mind. And just in case they don't protect, I'm going to Snarl so at least they get something out of this turn. But they're definitely going to protect, so I have to Calm Mind during their protect. I have to be just... I ran out of moves. Okay. I ran out of D-Gleams. And yeah, I'm going to Snarl. Dang it, they didn't do it! But again, the Snarl is going to be useful. It's gonna help me neutralize the damage that this thing is doing to me. Oh, actually, that was decent damage. What the heck? That's why I crit. Oh, well, I should have gone for the heat wave then, I guess. I might have actually KO'd it. All right, we ate. Nice. We ate that really well. I also have Calm Mind, buddy. And I also have Snarl. So I'm going to let you make this decision here. I think I Calm Mind again. I have Parabolic Charge. I can heal up. It might take me forever, but I have it. I'm going to Calm Mind again. I'm really going to try to punish his Protects. I wasn't paying attention if they were Cover Cloak. Oh, they're not Cover Cloak. They're lefties. I'm sorry. I saw that. Lefties. 1,000 times. So that just means I'm extremely unlucky with my heat waves, is what that means. Alright, we're at +4. We're still not matching their special defense, but I think we're now out-damaging their Giratina, technically. With our special attack. They depulse again, they're gonna get rid of my Chiyu. Okay. Woo! We got a spicy game here! They're not protecting, though. Okay, I guess they see what I'm doing. That's why they're not protecting. So they're just going for attacks instead. All right, into my Fluttermane. Oh, I have Taunt. Wait. Yeah, that's the win button. Taunt is the win button. If they can't Taunt, they can't protect. If they can't protect, I can hurt them. Hopefully. I'm currently +4. And they are... +3 in special attack and +5 in special defense, so. I should try to Calm Mind again. I think I'm gonna protect my Fluttermane this turn, because I'm gonna try to Calm Mind twice more. They're gonna focus on my Fluttermane, but just because the Fluttermane is the way to make this a 1v1. And it's the easy Shadow Ball there. I'm also trying to see if they get up protected. They're not going for it, though. They're finally playing a little aggressive here with this Giratina. Okay. Got that Protect call right, so that's really good for me. I could also get health back. It's all good. We'll both be here all day. Remember, guys, I have healing. I have Parabolic Charge. And they just lost a majority of their healing there with that grassy terrain. I think I go again. One more. We taunt the Giratina. Okay, I'll taunt you next turn. I got a free Calm Mind, my guy. I'll take it. Thank you very much. They saw the taunt now. They can't hide behind protecting lefties. Congratulations, my Maridon is +6. We did it! And +1 defense, because why not? All right. Electro Drift it is. I don't really have other moves to use. And we taunt here. Problem is, I might run out of PP before I'm able to knock this stupid thing out. That's the worst case scenario. Alright, let's just taunt this thing. Stop it from protecting for 3 turns at least. See how much this Electro Drift can do. Decent chunk! Very decent chunk! Oh, they Shadow Ball the other guy. Fine. I can eat it. Nice try, I guess. Giratina can't win it. And you know why I can't win it? Pachirisu got that early damage really, really soon. If you protect here... Oh, they can't. Never mind. I just taunted them. Even better. They have 2 turns left of this light screen. Let's kid that thing out of here. And I can now go for a Moonblast too while I'm here. Why not? I might get a special attack drop here. Nope. This is why I thought it's Cover Cloak. None of my secondary effects are going through. Alright, great damage there on Giratina. They Shadow Ball again. They're banking on a crit. They don't get it. No crits for you, and they can't protect. I played this game so sloppy. Not really. I think I played the game really, really well. I just remembered things sloppily. But that's a problem with me, not a problem with my gameplay. Alright, Moonblast. Little bit of chip. Electro Drift, the rest of the chip. Did this battle really take nearly 17 minutes? To- Are my eyes deceiving me? Now I understand why I made so many mistakes. There was 17 minutes worth of gameplay for me to forget. Wow! Okay, Oliver. I see you don't value your time playing things like Calm Mind Giratina on the ladder. Alright, whatever. Patchy gets a win. On to the next. Let's go. Up against Alex with his own Maridon. Okay, Maridon v. Maridon. Don't hate it here. Especially since, like, the whole bottom half of their team and the Maridon are weak to Fairy, so I can just Fairy Terror and have a fun time, I guess. But you know what? That's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna bring Maridon, bring the Pachirisu. It's what worked. Why wouldn't I do it again? I think I could also bring the Urse here. I don't hate an Urse. Definitely Chiyu in the back so I can have my damage boosted. Actually, will it even be beneficial to me though? Because they're gonna outspeed me, so I'm gonna help them out too. All right, maybe we hold the Chiyu. Maybe instead we just do Grim and Urse in the back. This puts a lot of stock on my Maridon, but I think with Grim in the back, I'm able to get up screens. I'm able to have a fake out turn. I could make my tanky Maridon even tankier. It might be worth it in the end. So yeah, let's bring the Grim there. Alex with the check mark, whatever that means. Okay. Urshifu Shen Pao. Ugh. Disgusting. Not a big fan at all. They're gonna ice bender me for sure. I'm timid, so I might outspeed. If they're not. I think I'm definitely forced the redirection here though. Let's just parabolic charge this turn. Yeah, steel tear doesn't help me. I guess standard Diglim is also fine. Yeah, I'm not gonna show them parabolic charge yet. But I will follow me. So I gotta follow me away this Urshifu's hit. I think I should live it thanks to... Oh, they're going in. Maybe this is probably why I should have parabolic charged. Yeah, they're gonna water tear the Ursh. Okay, fair. But I think I still live it with the Citrus Berry intact. I don't know about this Chen Pao being next to him, though. I'm max HP, max defense, and bold, so I'm as tanky as I can be right now as a Pachirisu. Alright, wish me luck. Alright, I live it. Neat. That's all I needed to know. I don't know if I would live the combination of that plus an Ice Spinner, but hopefully I outspeed the Ice Spinner. We'll see, though. Alright, Patchy's taking a lot of hits to the face right now. But you know what? That follow me is meaningful. We outspeed. Here's a nice little D-Gleam. Gonna leave the champ out at 1 HP. Followed by an Icicle Crash. No Ice Spinner. That's huge. Alright, Patchy. Thanks for coming. Now what? Life Orb! Get out of here. Bye. See you later. I don't mind that. Now I definitely bring Grimmsnarl then. Yeah, definitely Grimmy here. Free fake out turn for me. Thank you very much. Never mind. Take it back. What I can do now is Parabolic Charge, though. And if they do Trick Room, I have my Blurs in the back. I have that option. What is that? Electric Seed. Okay, so they're also Electric Seed there. If I Fairy Terror and Dazzling Gleam, that might be enough to knock out the Urshifu. I might just want to Calm Mind though. I'm a little greedy, I'll be honest. I could also just E-Drift this Ursh. Is there anything that wants to take an E-Drift? There's a couple things that do on their side of the field. Their own Maridon, for example. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna Fairy Terror Dazzling Gleam instead then. In case they do swap that out. And I'll set up a Reflect for now. Okay, they're not swapping. But I think a Fairy Terror D-Gleam considering how much the original D-Gleam did, is enough to just knock the Urshifu out anyway. And if they set Trick Room up, like I said, it'll be Maridon versus Maridon. I have no idea why they want to set Trick Room up. I would be a slower Maridon, probably. Oh, they're just HHing. That's bad. Please go for my Grimmsnarl. Because I just Fairy Terrored. Oh, dang, dude. Okay, good. Thank goodness. Thank goodness. Grimmsnarl, sorry, you're out of here, pal. But thanks for coming. Peace out, Cub Scout. Bye-bye. Woo! That could have been bad. Could have been real bad. Thankfully, I think this is enough to knock, though. Wish me luck. I can only pray. Thank goodness. Get that thing out of here. I don't want it. I want no part of that Ursh. That Ursh is spooky, man. Alright. Now we're kind of fine, I think. We got a Blurst now. I can't use Vacuum Wave, but I can use every other thing I have. They can't Terastalize away either. And I should be faster. I'm timid. They never said Trick Room up. Yeah, I think we're A-okay. I D-Gleam again. I throw an Earth Power into this Maridon. Battle is canceled. They don't even want to play no more. They're upset they chose the wrong target. Like, dang it. I could have just hit the Maridon. I could have been fine. Why didn't I just hit the Maridon? Yeah, why didn't ya? Sorry, Alex. GG's. On to the next. Dozo and Pelipper. Okay. Calyrex Shadow Team, too. Not a fun time today to be me, I guess. But you know what? Not a horrible time, either. There have been worse times to be me. Now, I think what we do against this team initially... we're gonna have to do a couple things. I'm gonna lead Grimmsnarl because I think I need screens against this. And then I'm gonna lead Maridon. See if I can get some Calm Minds going. I'll bring Patchy in the back. And then my last Pokemon, that's a tough decision here. But I think it has to be the Chiyu so I can deal with that Calyrex Shadow. At least a little bit. At least with Snarls and stuff. It also boosts the damage output of my Maridon. It's never a bad thing. Their team is just as special heavy as my team, except they have a Dozo on it. I think Dozo... with a Fairy Tear on my Maridon, I should be fine. Yeah. That's probably my best option. Whether I go Light Screen or not, turn one, I don't know. It really does depend on what they lead with. I might just decide to Fake Out and Calm Mind, though. Because I'm a little greedy. Little greedy today. Alright, basic trainer card. Yeah, time to change the eye color. You didn't have time to change your trainer card? What's going on? Horse Tatsu. What are they doing? Are they Psych Up Dozo? That's not the way that you would do it, though. Alright, in the face of these two goonies, I'm just gonna Light Screen, right? There's no point in faking out unless I'm predicting a Terra. I'm just gonna Light Screen. Do I Fairy Terror right away? Or should I start attacking right away now? I'm kind of feeling a little greedy, I'm not gonna lie. Maybe I Light Screen here? And I just show them what the electricity feels like, you know? Right away? I just want damage done, I think. I think I just want to hurt this thing. They're gonna tear. As long as you're not ground, we're fine. Okay, we're fine. I have my own one of those. What's the Tatsu doing? What's the plan for Tatsu here? Who knows? I guess I could have faked that one out, but I think I'd much rather have Light Screen up than just a fake out on a Tatsugiri. I mean, what I could have done is predict the tear, I guess, and fake out the horse, but it's fine. I'm okay with this less impressive, more good play. Yep, just a regular Astral Barrage here, nothing to see. And it crits me!
Why does that always happen, God? Why? That's the second time this week that happened to me. And all I did was muddy water. That's all I did was muddy water. I guess I lost. I don't know. Okay. That's always fun. You know, when I played a 17-minute battle game one, I couldn't get a single crit on a +5 Giratina, but this one guy on turn one, randomly against Kevin Sidonio, decides, hey, I'm gonna blow up your Maridon. What? Why do I play this game sometimes? Just win. Okay, Patchy lives +1 Astro Barrage. Anyone else impressed? I kinda am. Never mind, Patchy's dead. Alright, on to the next. Let's get out of here. Dondozo team with an Amoongus plus an Araquanid, okay. I got a team that got a bunch of Slowmons on it, but also a team that has a Zacian and a Dozo on it, so who knows what way they're trying to go. Tell you what, Electric Terrain goated this battle, that's for sure. And I think I'm just going Maridon and Patchy. This might actually might be the perfect Patchy game that I can get. Patchy can actually really pop off here. Now, as for my backline, I think I'm just going Flutterfish. Listen, I'm going to bring as much damage as humanly possible, because ever since last game happened, I'm starting to think that just clicking buttons and winning games is easy, you know? Let me just go for damage. Why click setup moves? What's the point? They're going to crit you. Yeah, I understand. I understand why crits are important for the game. I understand that, hey, if your opponent is setting up on you and gets the +6, that'll make a toxic game. You need the chance of, you know, breaking through all that stuff. I get it. But I think it should be scaled, you know? Maybe if there's no setup moves, no crits. The second you hit one setup move, okay, now you have a crit chance. You know, maybe that's a pretty decent option. I'm just saying. Might be playing a little bit of an antiquated format 25 years later. Anyway, what am I doing? Great question, Kevin. I think I'm just gonna go for a Super Fang, and I'm gonna click Calm Mind at least once. Yeah. Let's do that. This also covers us for their Dozo Terrestrialization, especially if it's a Dragon Terror here. It could also just protect Dozo. Maybe even Yawn Dozo. Oh, I hope they don't Yawn Dozo. That'd be bad. Also covers me for a Kowtow Cleave. Covers me for a lot here. Okay, they're protecting. That's fine, I guess. We got a free Calm Mind up. I'll take it. What's the King Gambit doing? Swords dancing? I have a feeling it's gonna Swords Dance in front of me. Okay, good. I Fairy Tarred. Eat. Alright, at this point, I'm gonna follow me. I'm gonna blow him up. Do I predict the Tatsu swap that much? Yes, right? They have to. So shouldn't I just Helping Hand boost and then Electro Drift, whatever the heck comes in here? Yes. That's what I'm gonna do. Something's gonna hurt, and it's not gonna be me! There's the Tatsu swap. Fine by me. I don't think this Dozo should be able to one-shot my Maridon. Of course, it always could. They also could Terrestrialize here. What are we thinking? Are we thinking the Dozo outspeeds my Maridon? I don't think so. I don't think it can. Maybe after one order up it can. But like currently, they didn't Terrestrialize, so I might just kill this thing. Good luck! Bye! And I didn't need a crit to do it. Wow, incredible. Woo! Okay, well, there goes Dozo. Thanks for coming. Thanks for stopping by. You did great, Dozo. Alright, my self-esteem and my ego are much higher this battle. Hi, Zacian. I'm not an idiot, so I'm not going to sit here and let you hit me. I'm going to go for Follow Me. And I'm going to go for Electro Drift. Into you now. May your behemoth blade go into my little squirrel. Never mind, I'm faster because you're not max speed. Goodbye, Zacian. Peace out. I'm just doing my Rhydon things now. And I don't need a crit to do it. That's what I'm saying. Okay, they muddy water. Fine by me. Next turn, it's gonna be a simple turn. They only got two Goonies left. I'm hitting Helping Hand. I'm hitting Parabolic Charge. Battle will be over. I think at least. I think that should be enough to KO both of them, hopefully. With the Electric Terrain on the field and with my free plus one. Maybe not KO the King Gambit. Definitely KO the Tatsu, though. Tatsu's special defense isn't all there. That works, too. All right. That's a nice little way to end. 3-1 overall in today's video. And do you really count that last one? I don't know. You tell me. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I hope you did enjoy Pachirisu. And also, thank you so much to our good old friend, Shumate. On Discord for going ahead and posting the Patchy team on Discord. I honestly think Shumate put a lot of thought into this team, and it looks like a lot of fun. And I like the fact that even if you aren't forcing yourself to play Patchy every single time, you have things like Flutterfish, you have things like Blursaluna, you have things like Grimmy to help you with secondary options with the team. Of course, I forced myself onto one way to play the game because I was trying to showcase the Pokemon. But you don't always have to bring the Patchy. You can technically just bring a Grim, set up screens, and just play the Calm Mind game, you know? But overall, I thought the team did pretty good. I didn't have like a horrible matchup, I think, at least not in today's video. Let me know what you guys thought down below, of course. Anyway, hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, like and comment on your way out. See you guys again here tomorrow for some more VGC. Have yourselves a great night. I'm Ken Spooky Sports. Peace out and bye-bye.